All right, let's try this out. Cool. All right, let's try this out. This is Dungeon of the Endless. It's a roguelike tower defense RPG hybrid. A little bit of strategy, too. You start with these four characters initially, and I have this guy because I have an expansion pack. And as you play the game, you find more characters, and if you beat three or four levels with them, you get keep them forever, and I've done it with these two so far. You get to start with two characters. I guess you can also pick different pods to start with, and of course I haven't unlocked any because I haven't beat the game or I haven't beaten these requirements. Essentially, these things are crashing down from space. And yeah. So, alright, I'm going to pick two characters. I really like her, and I like her. But I might go for the more defensive tank first and a runner. Well, let's see. Dude, he's pretty fast. I'm going to use her as my runner. I'm going to go with two melee guys to start. I don't think that makes much of a difference. I could be wrong, though. Alright, so you start the game off in your crashed pod. This crystal is the thing that you're trying to defend. And you control your characters either by clicking on them and then right-clicking. Now, you don't control them directly. You issue them commands to move from one room to another. Okay, so, kind of play it like an RTS a little bit. You can select multiple units. You can't click drag, but you can shift click on them, or you can use 1 and 2 to select them, or shift 1, shift 2, all that stuff. And you right click on doors to open them up, and things happen. Monsters, you get dust. The guys aren't automatically fight the monsters. In order to go to the next room, you can just right click, but first, where there's a dust up here, there are four resources: dust, food, science, and tech, industry. And I'll explain all these as we go. Dust is used to light up rooms, and in lit rooms, enemies won't spawn. So, do we have enough for anything? We do. Industry is used to buy buildings. Prisoner prod, and you use tech to research more of these, and for upgrades for those, and you use food to either heal your characters in combat, or to level your characters up. I'm going to turn this down a little bit, kind of loud. Alright, so let's continue on. Oh no, first let's put down an industry generator. And you can only build these big generators in this spot right here. And any of these, you can build on these little tiny circles. Now, we don't need any yet, so we're just going to save up. Alright, so now we actually have a choice to make. I'm going to head off to the right at first, and I'm going to light this room up. Nothing. Don't like that. I don't like any of those, so we're going to just leave it alone for now. You can destroy that with this little tool, and you can put something else down on it, but I don't have enough industry. Now, there are certain monsters that will ignore your characters, like these guys, and they will go straight for this, but they didn't. I was able to kill them in time. And you can also just move from room to room after as well. Alright, now this is the exit room. And what the exit room is, it's an exit. Shit, that's not good. 7. What you do with the exit room You have to move... The objective of each level is to move this, your dust diamond thing, to here. Any room that is not lit will spawn monsters, or if you don't have somebody that's standing in it, as you'll guys see in just a second. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to build another industry generator here. And I'm going to use that room as an example. Let's see. 30%. I have not tried this yet. I'm going to give it a shot, see how it goes. All right, so I'm going to open this room. Enemies are going to be in here. And then, as you'll see here in a second, possibly... No, they didn't spawn that time. Okay, so we're kind of in a rough spot. We don't have enough dust to start to brighten another room, but I wanted to keep them there. All right. Now, over here. Now you'll see that there's stuff spawning. Now, after we kill these guys, we're going to move over here. And they're gonna, well, attack us because, you know, your character also automatically healed into combat. That's why I'm not worried about it right now. So the turn's over. I can heal now. I can also level up these characters. And it costs 15 food to do it for this guy and 30 for this guy. I don't know why this guy costs so little, but... Characters also have different stats. Health, HP regen, defense, speed. There's their DPS, which is calculated by combination of those and wit. All this is kind of self-explanatory. Wit is something that comes into play later on in the game. It's dictates how fast you can repair modules, and you can also help. You can also modify those modules as well. Let's actually go here. Shoot, wow. Took some damage. Okay. Now we have enough, so I can light that room up. I'm gonna bulldoze this and build a food replicator so we can get a little bit more food going. I'm gonna put her right here. No. Her right there. So there might be some that spawns in those two rooms. That's okay. Move him back. Something spawned in that one. That's alright. We're gonna defend right here and we're gonna pause it. I guess we don't have to build those yet. Oh shoot. Wow. Should be able to level her up, yep. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use this as a staging area for the rest of the level. And build these prisoner pods, they'll automatically attack enemies. So now, I'll put her here. That's closed off. This should be the last one right here. Nope. Oh wow, it's a pretty big level for the start. So everything that comes in here, I will be able to auto attack. All the lasers will do work. Okay. And as you kill enemies, sometimes they'll drop dust. It's based on different probabilities for stuff. This guy has a reduced chance, but he's easier to level up, so... And this is kind of the general gameplay of the game. It starts off pretty simple at the start. As you get more characters, it gets a little more complex. Good. No, not enough yet. Damn it. It's really rough for a first level. Now, I could just pick up the cube right away and go for the exit, but I want to try to maximize my industry and all my stats. Dust isn't taken over to the next level. You always start with around, like, 20 to 29. Matter of fact, I'm going to use her to start running. This should be the last one right here. No, not yet. Ooh, she's pretty weak. I'm gonna put some prisoner pods here. Maybe try to weaken them as they come through. I'll do a little bit of damage, not much, but... yeah, she's surprisingly weak. Alright, so now we have enough to light up another room. I'm gonna go with this one, I think? Yeah. Now I'm gonna delete one of these and put in this dust field gen, which should give me 30% more defense, which will be very, very useful. Run him there. Here's the last one. He's just that one room. Yeah, good. Okay. Oh, no. Oh. So I've maximized what I can get out of this. There are no more doors to open up. These numbers go up every time you open up a door. So now what I have to do is get her to the exit. To do that, you right-click, and you click that, and all hell breaks loose. Uh-oh. Okay. And then you just take it here, make sure both your characters are there. You tend to want to pick a character with high move speed because they're very slow when they're carrying that. And this is sort of the tower defense element of it. You build stuff to kill. And whenever you have all the guys here, you click it whenever you want. You're not really going to do too awful much. Now, things will attack these, your generators. So you want to keep them off of certain paths. Go ahead and exit. And... there's funny stuff, they say. Tells you how many doors you had, monsters killed, all that fun stuff. And how many floors. What floor you're at, all that stuff, and your score. And then you move on. And every level has a different setup. It's randomly generated, and this is level 2. So we're just going to move straight down to the next room. Get her out of there. Wow. Okay. So we're going to start off with another industry generator. And I'm going to send him in first. Very tanky. Like, over triple the health. Light this room up. Let's see what kind of research we can do. These are research, by the way. That is a really good one. So this one over here. And sometimes sending your characters in different orders can be very helpful. Notice that she's not taking as much damage now. There we go. Light this one up. I'm going to put a food generator in. So maybe we can start leveling up our guys a little bit faster. And every time you level up, they gain more health, a little more damage, all that fun stuff. Kind of like a traditional RPG. Ooh, chest. Nice. Chests give you items, like the 2-2, which I'm going to give to her because it increases defense and speed. I want her to be a little more tanky, a little faster. So now, I don't have enough dust to light this room, so I have enough. I'm going to send her in. I do have enough to light this one now. Okay. So we kind of have a dilemma. There's not a dilemma because she's fast. I'm going to use this one to open the doors. And then I'm going to use her to run over here after the door's been opened. No dust in this room. Oh, that's bad. I moved her too fast. This is a little bit of a pickle. Now, this should be okay for now. So we're going to... That's nice. That's really good right here. These offshoot rooms are very, very good. That's not so good, though. It doesn't have a... it does have a chest. That's nice. Hipster scarf. Get her out of there for a second. Put her back in. Alright, so let's see what the hipster scarf does. First. Oh, well, of course. It unlocks us. That's really good, actually. Okay. So, is that a self-powered room? Sometimes you'll come across self-powered rooms, and that lets you build something else on them. In this case, I'm going to go for another food replicator. It's really nice. Ooh, yes, recruit another character. So, what that did, I now have this new character on my team. Elise, she's... Pirate. Oh, that's really good. She does cost more to heal, but that's okay. I have this person to be a tank. And she can't wear any armor. Oh, that's bad. Two devices. But okay. So I'm going to have her in here. And her in here. So all of these guys spawn, and this one, and that one. Don't have enough food now to heal anymore, which is why I want these food replicators. Damn, this is a very rough one so far. Matter of fact, I'm going to take that one out, put that one in here, so I have a nice staging area. Dust field, I think that's more important right now. So again, we'll go here, we're gonna go here. We have an option between right and down now. We go right. And we're immediately gonna run back in this room. That's the exit, good. He's spawning up here. Okay, now we can do that. That's clear now. No, actually we're gonna clear that one. So we can move her here. A merchant. Oh, let's see if anything spawns. No. Okay. So merchants are another aspect of the game. Each merchant uses different things. And in this case, uses science, which is not very good. Of course, I don't have much anything. I don't know why I'm looking at this stuff, but... Okay. That's that's the last door. Okay, so that's it's just right there. And we're gonna move. Ooh, wow.